completed, Scotty. Ignore that curtain right there. I'll explain later. This is the outside of our Scotty 1962 Serro Scotty Sportsman. As you can see, we've done a lot of work to it. So those are the tires that we received with the Scotty. We painted the hubcaps, and those are not original Scotty hubcaps. So this is our electrical port that we put in for shore power, and we also run our solar panel cords through there. I'll show you in a moment. So here's the front windows of the Scotty. Excuse my messy garage. Those are our solar panels. You can see we've already taken this camper out. There's a lot of mud on the front there. So right now our solar panels are hanging out of this window, only because when we have the camper parked, I like to take the solar panels and put them out in the driveway to charge, to keep the batteries charged. And this is the entrance, the front door entrance. So full disclosure, I shot a video earlier and it was so dark. I was like, there's no way you guys are gonna wanna watch that. So I had to reshoot this video. But here you can see we have storage in these two boxes, mostly additional electrical supplies, and then food storage down at the bottom. That's a IKEA bag and a dustpan and broom. Here's our porta potty and our TP box. That's where we keep our toilet paper, and our porta potty underneath this seat. And it's a really small camper. It's nothing, you know, too elaborate. But all of the cushions were made by me. This is actually an IKEA table, a lack table, L-A-C-K. So we just took this table, I put some foam on top of it, and then batting and material, and you know, that's what we get. So I have two of those up here in the front. Instead of rebuilding a full bench, would have eaten into the kitchen space right here, and that's precious real estate right here for the kitchen, because we wanted a bigger bed, and we wanted the bed ready to go all the time. So there's no like folding it up and making it into a couch and pulling it back down. There's very limited headroom in here. I'm 5'4" and I probably have 2 to 3 inches of head clearance while standing inside this box. If I'm standing on this surface right here, I'll be hitting my head. So anyone that's 5'4" or 5'6" or smaller would be able to stand up in here perfectly fine without hitting their head. Maybe 5'7". But this is the bedside of the camper. So this window right here, I made this curtains to go in that window, but realized the rod is too short. So I have to get a much longer curtain rod to fit into the window frame. This is where we keep most of our food storage right now. Sorry about that. We have some lighting. This is just a regular cabinet. Keep our spices up here, and have a fan, a 12-volt fan back there. This is our coffee machine, spice rack, just standard things that we would need while camping. I thought this was my happy place, but it's very hot in here right now. Oops. So we use a rocket pump faucet, and I'll show you how that works. It's just, you pump it and water comes out. And then down below here, this is our gray water tank, and that's 5 or 6 gallons. And this is our 6-gallon fresh water tank. And because we have the rocket pump, it's a really simple hookup. So you can see the clear hose back here. And then this is where the water drains into our gray water. this cord right here, these cords are the cables to the solar panels. So when we're out camping, we pull these cords in from outside through the front window and run them through that hole right there, and then put the solar panels on the outside of the camper near any shore power that we may have, or in the maximum sun possible. So the rest of the setup for the electrical is through this little hole where the cables for the solar panel are going through, and I'll show you the rest of that. So right alongside the bed is where I keep our control panels for all of our electrical. This is our MPPT charge controller for the solar panels. When it's connected or hooked up, it reads out the how much power is coming in from the sun to the solar panels, so how much intake of power we're getting. It also shows us how much output from the batteries that we're putting out, and it basically just keeps the batteries from being overcharged through the solar panels, and it regulates all of that. This is our I have a, I think it's a 4,000 watt inverter, and I could be wrong, maybe it's a 2,000 watt inverter, but this is the controller or the keypad for that. I then put in this really simple, they use these on boats, but this is where I have a 12 volt charger there and USB ports here. This also gives you the voltage readout for what's coming off of your battery. I also have another USB charger and three 12 volt chargers on the side. I hook this up here because this is the plug for it, which is also 12 volt. So that can then go into this hole, into this 12 volt charger. This is hooked up directly to the battery. And once I turn that on, this is running the refrigerator, which is this cord here. So my refrigerator is also 12 volt, and that plugs into one of these, and then I just turn this on and the refrigerator is running at that point. It frees up this 12 volt because it seemed like I only had one at the moment. So once I plug this into here, I've now lost any other 12 volt access that I may need. I have a 12 volt fan and some other appliances that run on 12 volt. So if I put my refrigerator into here and then plug this into the one 12 volt port that's connected to the battery, I now have two additional 12 volt ports that I can use to run my fan and some additional USB chargers there as well. So they use these on boats, these control panels. It has switches on there for lights and whatever, what have you. Your water pump maybe hooked up to one of these, and this is the control panel that controls that. So you're probably wondering, where does all of this stuff connect to? And I'll show you the way that we have it connected. It's all in this little trap door under the mattress. So, hang on. Under here is where the battery is connected. I have the batteries running. I have two AGM sealed marine grade batteries, and I have them connected in serial. So the two batteries are connected to each other, and they're 80 amp hours apiece, so that's 160 amp hours. So when they're connected in series, they draw the same amount of power as one battery. So instead of doubling my voltage, these are 12 volt batteries. When you hook them up in parallel, you will double the voltage, and then two 12 volt batteries will become a 24 volt battery. I took my two 12 volt batteries and connected them in series so that they're the same 12 volts coming off the battery, so that I can use 12 volts on these. And so it holds a lot more power. It's 160 amp hours now instead of just 80 amp hours. It's a little confusing, but I'm sure some of you know what I'm talking about. Anyway, this is the camper. I'm now going to go ahead and just insert some of the images for the actual build out. I forgot to mention we have storage down below the bed as well. So these are probably 40 quarts or 40 gallon tubs. I have four of them under here, two on each side. Well, two can fit on each side. I have four. Those two are stacked one inside the other. But underneath here is where I have the inverter. You really can't see it down there, but that's where it's hooked up to. And it's where we toss our keys. This is a cute little trap box that we use to cover the wheel wells. And inside here, we store things like, you know, batteries and flashlights. I'll use one now to show you the inverter. So there's the inverter. That gray cord you see there is what's connected to the control panel up above. Tells you how much juice your battery has for your inverter, or is putting out to your inverter. So yeah, this is the complete build out of the camper. I know I promised it to you guys, so here it is. I'm going to go ahead and insert the images, the pictures from the build out. So thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Click the little bell so you're reminded as to when more videos are coming out. And I promise you there will be more videos. Also, go ahead and thumbs up this video if you like it. And don't forget to share with your friends and family and get my views up. All right. Thanks for watching. Have a great one. Bye.
Bird on a tree, I'm just sitting here. I got time, it's clear to see. From up here, the world seems small. We can sit together, it's so beautiful, you and me. We meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free. Step back to see the truth around you. From a distance you can tell. You and me were meant to be in the great outdoors, forever free.